here's how to use Google Keep. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and this is your Google Keep tutorial for beginners. So what is Google Keep? Google Keep is a free note-taking, list-creating task manager from Google, and there are multiple reasons you should be using Google Keep. So here's how to use Google Keep. Part of learning how to use Google Keep is to understand how to access Google Keep. There are a few ways to do so. You can do so from the mobile app, but one of the easiest ways is to access it directly from any tab in your Google suite of apps. So whether that's Gmail, Gcal, Drive, and so on, you can find Google Keep on the right-hand side of your screen. It's a little yellow square with a light bulb in it. Alternatively, you can head to keep.google.com to access a full screen version of your Keep account. So let's work off of here for this tutorial so we can go more in depth. On the left-hand panel here at the top is Notes, and under that is Reminders. Directly underneath those is where you're going to be able to view labels and create or edit labels to better organize your notes. But I'll get into more details about the left-hand panel in a bit. So here in the main section of the screen will be where any notes or task lists you've created live. But right above that is a text box that says, "Take a note." This is really where you can get started on creating and organizing new notes and tasks or reminders. So click in that text box, and here you can add a title to your note. This is why I find Google Keep really handy. If I'm on a client call and I need to take notes, I can quickly create my note right here and type in all of the important details as we're talking about them. So then it's saved digitally rather than in some notepad somewhere that I'm gonna misplace the next day. So we're typing out our new note, and once everything is in, you can either organize or customize the note right from here as you're creating it, or you can click off the note and it'll appear in your notes section of Google Keep here. So now let's dive into some of the great features found within a note. Hover your mouse over the note you created to access a row of options along the bottom. In the bottom left corner is the bell symbol. This is where you can set a reminder, which is so handy if you need to follow up on something later and don't want to forget. To set a reminder, just click that bell icon and you can set it to when you want to be reminded, but you can also set a place to be reminded. So click pick a place and then you can just type in the address of the location. So imagine you created a packing list for your trip, you can pick the address of your favorite outdoor store, and now Google Keep will send you a notification of your packing list when you arrive at that store. How neat is that? So now let's talk about the collaboration feature. This time when you hover your mouse over that note, click the collaborator icon. Then in this pop-up here, you can add a person or email that you want to share the note with. This is another feature I love because if you're on a client call and it's a group call, you can be the note taker or assign a team member to be a note taker who can then share all the meeting notes with everyone that was on the call. You can add as many people as you want and you don't even have to have a Gmail account. They'll still get an email notification asking them to collaborate on a note. Once you've collaborated on a note, you'll have icons at the bottom of the preview indicating those that are shared on the note. Anytime you're done editing a note, by the way, you can click off of it to get out of that note. So now you may notice that some of my notes here are different colors. Hover over a note and click on the background options icon. Here you can simply select a new color. So this is handy if you're into color coordinating your notes, kind of like iColor calendar block in Gcal, and you can add specific color for maybe a specific task or client. But you can also add a background to a note if you so desire. To the right of the background options is the option to add an image to your note. Again, if you're big on visual cues and organization, you can just click that icon and select an image from your computer, and it's going to be added right to the top of your note. The next feature is the archive option. This is not the same as deleting a note. Archiving is great for when you're all done with that note or task list and you don't want to delete it, but you'd like to clear the clutter from your main notes page. Simply archive it. It gets removed from the main notes page, but if you select the archive option on the left-hand panel of your screen, you'll have all of your archived notes there. And don't worry if you archived by mistake or if you have to reopen a note or project. If you hover over that note, now you have the option to unarchive it and it would move it back to your note section. You can of course fully delete a note by clicking the three-dot menu icon in the note and selecting delete note. Now this will move it to your trash bin, which you can access as well on the left. You can manually empty your trash bin, but notes are automatically removed from your trash bin after 7 days. So I'm gonna head back to notes at the top so we can go over even more features. Hover over your note again and click the more menu in the bottom right. The second option here is the option to add a label. And I touched on this a little bit earlier, but this is really key for organizing your notes. Think if you had thousands of notes all floating around in here, you'd have to manually search for anything and everything. But if you add labels, you can quickly find anything you're looking for. So click add label, and here you can either create a new label or add it to a label you've already created. So now on the left-hand side of the screen, you can quickly drill down your notes per label. Love it. Plus, all of these little customized features we're adding will be viewable at a quick glance of your note. So it's like adding customized tags to every note. So like this one is tied to an address. This one is labeled for YouTube and so on. So I'll hover over a note again and click the more menu. Here, you can also add a drawing. This opens a window where you can add a drawing to your note. Now, it seems really silly, this horrible maple leaf I'm doing, but let's say you work better by sketching out a layout or a logo idea or something. This would really be a good collaboration tool. So back in the more options section of a note, you can make a copy of a note. This is really handy if you're gonna be making similar notes, so rather than create it from scratch, make a copy of it, and it'll copy the note over and the label over. So things like location and collaborators won't be copied over. But then you can just edit that new copied note however you wish. And another feature in the More menu is the ability to show check boxes. This is handy if you like to check things off your to-do list. You can actually click off completed tasks off of your list as you go. So I prefer this view for a task list, but you can also hide the checkboxes too. Another feature in the More menu section is to copy a note over to your Google Docs. If you click that option, your note will automatically be copied over to Docs, where you're going to have all your info there in doc format. But there's something found in that More menu that's newer to Google Keep. And I just love this. You can click on version history to see the different versions of your note. From this pop-up, you will see the current version you're on, you'll see previous versions, when they were created and edited, including the date and time, and by whom. Plus, you can download any of those versions from here too. This is such a good Google Keep 2024 update. Now, we talked a little bit about labels and how powerful of an organization tool they are. But if you want to edit or delete a label at any time, you can click on Edit Labels from the left menu. And then in this pop-up box, you can click the pencil icon to the right of a label to edit the name. Or if you hover over the label, the trash bin will appear to the left of that label name, and you can select that if you just want to delete a label. A couple of other things to keep in mind is that you can change the layout of your Google Keep page. If you click on the rectangles near the top right of your screen, you will toggle to list view if you prefer that over this grid look. I happen to prefer the grid view, so I'm going to toggle back right here. There is also a settings gear in the top right where you can enable dark theme. So if you're working at night and you don't want a bright screen, you can change the view to dark theme. By the way, all of this can be done from your mobile Google Keep app as well. So let's say in fact you are working on the mobile app and you've made a note, but for some reason you come back to your desktop here and you don't see it. Just hit the refresh button near the top right, and then your mobile note should appear. And the reverse is the same as well. We did all of this from keep.google.com, but if you're actually watching this video, you might remember I told you you can get to Google Keep from any of the tabs in your Google suite of apps. So here's how that actually looks. So to give you an idea of Google Keep within the ecosystem, I'm gonna head to my Google Calendar here, and to the right, I've got the little Google Keep icon. click on the icon and the side panel opens up where you can create a new note or list, see all of your existing notes, edit an existing note, all right from the tab that I'm already in. This is actually the main way that I create notes and lists in Google Keep. I basically live out of my Google suite of apps, so I'm either in Gmail or GCal or Google Docs. So as I need to quickly create a reference note, I can do so without having to open a new tab and lose my place or train of thought with where I'm at. I definitely recommend taking advantage of that Google Keep shortcut right from the page that you're in. And I go into a ton more detail on Google Keep in my Everything Google course, which you can find via the link in the description below. So that's your Google Keep tutorial for beginners. Do you use Google Keep? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Keep content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.